savage, I collect my boy. Heard you is gorillas, let me check my boy. Say nothing silly, you regret my boy. Cause we got banana on the my boy. And I can send it in a text, my boy. Thumbs up or the emoji with the flex, my boy. Personalize every threat, my boy. Toll free, that's direct, my boy. And if you need a couple, I'm the connect, my boy. Off the top,
I just sprint it off the top.
I'm the best, as you know, as you know. And I gang on my own, on my own. Keep my way up, keep my way up, keep my go. If I touch it, then it's cold, then it's cold. I'm the best, as you know. But he not on the schedule. I'm taking a f- from my who ain't heavy. I'm the best, and you heard what I said. Dripping out of money, I'm dripping, it's spouting. Got on it, then it's dripping like water. Teaching a cook, but I don't have a daughter. I know me, I can pick up when I call it. Working big, and it don't hurt the brain, cause I'ma always do it how I wanna do it. Every time he need a know it, Mr. Cook, know I got him running to it. I'ma need to pull the mail before we talk it out. I'm waking up and thumbing through it. Running like a runner, do it. Stun on her till like a stunner, do it. I'm the best. I'm really with Kim Chose. Put my name up like a banner boat. Acting tough and I'ma let her go. Name a who got a banner flow. She can hang it up just like a telephone. Cost 10K to let it come see. Being them young, make it come treat it. Huh, being making it come beat. I want to move it in the machine up.
Southern California has a new modern home for NFL football, and it is this place, wondrous SoFi Stadium here in Inglewood.
Straight ahead, we punch the second of two tickets to the AFC title game, and we've got one last story between the Cincinnati Bengals and the Los Angeles Chargers. For a berth in the AFC championship game, off we go in the divisional round of the NFL playoffs.
This shit, bro. Wow, this is what the fuck we dealing with, huh? First fucking play of the game.
It's so simple. Ball security, so important in a game like this.
Running on first down and there. And this will be a gain of six when it's all said and done. Down to the 15 from the 21.
Hey, it's not the most spectacular play, but I think most teams will take that every single time for the first play of a drive. Begin the series with positive yardage and set yourself up for a very manageable second down.
They'll fake the handoff. Now Herbert. Chargers are on the board first here in this division round matchup. Hopkins with the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. Following the touchdown, Dustin Hopkins will kick it away. And a fair catch signal for and taken successfully. First and 10 at their own 25-yard line. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Forced out to his left.
Come on, man.
Intercepted. picked off by J.C. Jackson. And he's going to get this one to the 23-yard line. It's certainly not how they envision the start to this one. Give up the touchdown, and they take a shot on the first play from scrimmage offensively, but it gets intercepted.
Yeah, instead of just trying to nibble and, you know, work your way downfield, they tried to take a nice little chunk there. It didn't pay off for them. Now the defense runs on the field, having already given up a touchdown.
Touchdown, Chargers! Gerald Everett, two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Chargers are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Extra point good by Hawkins. And that'll make the score 13-0. Following the touchdown, Dustin Hopkins will kick it away. From his end zone, here's Trent Taylor. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. Here we go. The Bengals drive about to get going. And they're in an early hole. The first drive, they threw the interception. That led to a touchdown. So, decent-sized deficit early on.
It is, but I think you hit the key words early on. So, they have to decide, do we even need to change game plan? Or do we just need to execute better and try and get back in this game?
The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. Now, Burrow. That one taken in by T. Higgins. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. In a wild card win last week, he had just two catches, and now he's got his first one here.
You can almost hear the siren leave coming from their sideline and from their point on the field, because this has been a tough start for them thus far. A much-needed first down there. They've needed something good to happen. Plays like that will continue to help them dig out of this hole.
They'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. Plays like we just saw there. That's why they're up right now. And the defense, they're doing their job.
Yeah, it starts with the guys up front. So when you talk with GMs who are putting together a team, a lot of them say, we're going to build from the inside out. Because if you control the line of scrimmage, you control the rest of the ball game, and that's what we're seeing here. They're actually playing in the offense's backfield, not necessarily just playing at the line of scrimmage.
Now a deep ball here, called in just past the 50. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Just one catch for him last week in the wild card win, but getting involved early here and picks up the first. So from Charger territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 46. We're going to give this to Mixon. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple, and that's it.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly. That was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
The last run good for two. Here's second and 8. Burrow now, off the bootleg. And he gets this in the hands of Mixon. And he'll be brought down just shy of the 40.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense, because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get out to your running back, and it can turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding them to a short gain.
Seventh play of the drive upcoming here on 3rd and 6. Burrow going to fake to mix it and now look to throw. Open receiver, that's Hayden Hurst, the tight end. And he's brought to the ground with another first down at the Chargers' 12-yard line. That one goes for 29 yards on 3rd down.
But give them credit for a good read right there, because they read the man coverage on the right side and sent the tight end a few steps down the field and then angled him to the left on a crossing route. He was able to get enough separation on this play to turn it into a nice game.
And he goes back for a tear. Losing yardage back to the 16. Yikes, a 3-yard loss really sets him back now for 2nd down.
They have 3 tight ends in that formation. That's almost a universal sign that they're planning to run the football. But how about the defense there? They met force with force and caused a stack up behind the line of scrimmage and threw him for a loss.
Now second and 14 now after the loss. Here's Burrow setting up to throw it to Mixon in the check down. They'll wind up getting just a yard out of it. And it'll be a third and about 13.
We see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
And he will not be able to get the first as he can get this only down to the five. And pick up 10, but it'll still lead to a fourth down.
Nice job understanding the situation. Third and long, kept the play in front of them and made the tackle. They gave up a good chunk of yardage, but it does force a fourth down.
McPherson's kick is good. So a long drive gets him down inside the five, but ultimately they settle for just the field goal.
And I have to think that if maybe they were a yard closer, that would have made their decision tougher, and I think they likely would have gone for it. But in this situation, they just decided to take the three, and I think it was a smart move.
All we need to do is settle down. That's all we got to
do. So after the made field goal, here's McPherson to send this one away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The Charger drive about to get going. So for this offense, Charles, remember, drive one made it to the end zone. Drive two resulted in the touchdown as well. Now they're trying to make it
stuff his ass.
Yeah, and you know, they told us all week that this was the plan and this is what they wanted to execute, but did they really believe it would happen this well, this efficiently? I know they'll take it. And afterwards, they'll say, there was never a doubt in our minds we were going to be successful in this one.
Run got three. Now here's second and seven. Justin Herbert looking to pass.
Oh my fucking God, man. Come on, man.
And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. Herbert on first down now. They were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful when you're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz game, and you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try to cover downfield.
The end result, 21 yards. Herbert will give this one to Eckler. Able to fight for about 4 yards there to the 13.
Well, they didn't get a whole lot out of that one, but I think you got to continue to try and run and try to keep the defense honest.
You mean, or else just sit back, dare you to throw it on every down?
Yeah, you get your quarterback hit a lot that way, too.
Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. Back to throw here, Herbert.
Look at this guy just standing there, man.
So 5 yards here, five on the play. And they'll be faced with a third and inches.
They kept the receiver in the short field, but that let his quarterback get the ball quickly to him before either guy in double coverage could react.
After one, a 14-3 ball game. Seven coming on this drive. It's third and inches. They'll try to pick up the first.
Stuff his ass. Let's go.
And that one going nowhere.
Go for it, Craig.
He's met in the backfield and goes backwards. That'll back him up 2 yards and also bring up fourth.
That was well played there defensively. Two tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave them seven blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through, but that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
Herbert jogs off, and out comes Dustin Hopkins to take this kick for LA on fourth down. Hopkins' kick is good.
Shit, it's supposed to be picked off, man.
So a nice kick there as they are able to add on to the lead.
And that's exactly what you're looking to do. Maneuver yourself into range. That way, if your drive stalls out, you're able to get something out of it. And they do so right there.
On the return, it's Taylor from his end zone. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15.
There we go.
The Bengals drive about to get going. Their drive last time, it stalled out. They were forced to take the short field goal.
And the key phrase, you nailed it. Forced to, because you know coaches look at these short field goals as a last resort. Right to them, that's not how a drive was supposed to end. You're supposed to put six on the board. That's a consolation prize. Like going to the county fair, you don't get the big stuffed animal on that one, do you?
No, you don't get a top shelf. That's bottom shelf material. They go play action now. Burrow. And that's caught inside the 25.
Fucking go, man. We come here to lay down today.
Inside the 25.
I think this defense was still trying to recover from that last play, so you wonder if they were ready for this one. You have to imagine their defensive coaches are yelling out to get focused, because if they don't, more plays like that will result in giving up points.
And able to work his toenail. Toilet tissue.
Down. Making mistakes. I'm down. Fighting back. Fighting back. Oh, yeah.
Again, it's Mixon.
Let's go, Blow.
And able to get
it. Damn, it's holding.
Does reach the five. So that time, they got the left guard with a hold.
Thank you.
And let's face it, in today's ball, you might have that 330-pound guy you're supposed to clear out of there. You might need a little bit of extra help. Grabbing the jersey and trying to ride him out.
Play action. It's Burrow. Steps away.
Come on, man. We ain't coming right out, baby. Let's go.
T. Higgins. 23 yards for the touchdown. And the Bengals.
We need to stop, baby. We need to stop. Fucking go.
Extra point by McPherson. Up and good. And that slices the lead down to 17-10.
Put that pressure on him.
To the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away.
Come on, let's settle down, defense. Let's settle down now. Let's settle down.
And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased, and they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But it's like they know they did put points on the board. And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily, though.
So they come up in Bengals territory now with a 1st and 10 at the 46. Eckler now between the tackles. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about 4, 2nd and 6.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown. So a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game. Trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now. Hopefully get to the perimeter later. And let's face it, you could do worse than a 4-yard run on first down.
Make that tackle.
He'll be brought down just shy of the 40.
I know it was a game, but you have to sense probably a little bit of disappointment there, because when it's out there in open space, I think they expect to get more out of a play, don't you?
Especially when you're getting into your guy out of the backfield. You're expecting him to be able to create something, be a little more shifty.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Good open field tackling held him to an okay game.
From the go, get out the
fuck out of you, bro.
Damn. Inside the 10. They'll head out of bounds inside the 10. Mark it down at the 9. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
Well, you don't have to be a genius to watch this game and figure out that they've had plenty of success moving the football here in the first half. We've seen exhibits A, B, C, and right on down the line, haven't we?
Yeah, we just saw exhibit Z right there. Up the middle with Eckler.
Tough as that.
Pushes forward from maybe 3 down to the 6-yard line.
That's good power football on first and goal. A lot of teams will throw from there, but that's a nice job to chew up a few more yards and get yourself closer to the goal line.
The 6 yard line, the line of scrimmage on second and goal. Now it's Herbert. And this will be caught in the end zone for the Chargers touchdown. There's Hopkins now for the extra point. Touchdown, Dustin Hopkins will kick it away. Trying to keep pace. They did score the touchdown last time out, but they scored
three.
See if this offense is once again up to the task.
Yeah, and I think that after the last drive, what they got, they pretty worked up, don't you think? Everything they were doing was working pretty well. They go back out there with the same mindset, the same tempo, the same pace. Still a lot of time left to make something happen in this one.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Burrow will throw. He'll drop this one down to Mixon. They'll wind up getting 7 on the play. And that would get a 3rd and 4. In search of 3 yards here to pick up the first down. Now it's Burrow. He's got Hurst, his tight end. And he is going to have a Bengals first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
Normally on 3rd down and short yardage, you're thinking of throwing to your tight end. It's just going to be a simple chain mover. But this time they let him roam down the field, and a nice dart picks up the 1st down, and then some.
Mixon with a 1st down carry.
Come on, Nick.
Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. Really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
2nd quarter action, 2 minutes to go on divisional round weekend. A reminder, as we did all through the regular season, we'll check in with Jonathan Coachman at halftime. He'll have highlights and analysis of this 1st half of play. Still 9 remaining on 2nd down. They'll stay on the ground. Mixon again. And he's going to be stopped up at about the 47-yard line. They are in need of 6 yards here. They hope to move the chains. On 3rd down, Burrow. Over the middle, he finds Higgins. And he's brought to the ground with another 1st down at the Chargers 36. The Bengals passing game finding a rhythm. They've got another 1st. So from the 36 now, 1st and 10. Off the play fake, here's Burrow being chased out left. And he knocks the ball away and it falls incomplete.
He certainly had a good game throwing the ball so far, but I think he was trying to take that from good to great with that throw, trying to get one downfield.
We'll try again from the 36 on 2nd and 10. They go play action with Burrow. Buying time to his left.
Oh my! Oh my God, bro. I read the wrong fucking button.
Play comes to a halt at the 33, and obviously that's well short of the 1st down. Now the defense going to use the 1st of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime.
McPherson's kick is
wow, fucking over.
And we'll get the disadvantage now. All right, down to 11. So the margin shrinks a bit as back-to-back drives here for him in with field goals.
Yeah, we know no one's turning down three, especially in the first half. But you got
Molina's turnover, man.
That's got to be a priority. Nice tackle, reliable kicker. But outside of his agent, you know you'd rather him kick.
We need a goddamn turnover. We need that. Right now.
The Charger drive about to get going. Just inside of a minute left, Charles. They got a pretty long field ahead of them. I'm curious to see how they play this, but you would think definitely enough time to at least try to get three out of this.
Yeah, you want to move with a nice sense of pace. You have to tackle a little bit, but you have to do it with some poise as well. You don't want to go so fast that you hurry yourself into mistakes. There's enough time to put points on the board if they do it right.
Careful, Wagga! Turnover, baby!
And he brings this one all the way back to the 5-yard line.
So first thing that crossed my mind is why didn't they just sit on the lead and take it to the locker room? They're in good shape.
Absolutely. And from this spot on the field, now you've given the other side a chance for points here going into intermission.
Yeah, you changed the momentum of the game, and it's something you didn't
do. Can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Now the Bengals going to use the first of their timeouts. As they'll stop the clock with 26 seconds to go until halftime.
Well, that's an excellent way to get the pass rush activated. The first sack of the game for them comes on the first play of the drive, and it makes it very tough for the opponent to pick up a first down now, playing behind the sticks.
So second and long, and got to be careful not to fall out of field goal range. From the gun again to Mixon, and he'll be targeted at the 33 following a gain of 3. And guess what? It brings up third down. Timeout called for by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. A chance of wasting this great starting field position. Real threat. This is third and long. This is Mixon on the draw. And he's able to break out of one tackle, but then quickly brought down. Just a 1-yard pickup there, and it'll be fourth down. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. McPherson's kick is good, and that will do it for this first half. So it's on to halftime in this AFC Divisional Round matchup as we send you to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach? And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, set and ready to move for the third quarter. Win or go home, that's the name of the game. And we're back underway with the second half of this AFC Divisional Round. And no fireworks to start the half. This will be a touchback.
All right, fellas. Let's settle down. Definitely settle down here.
And they're in the position they expected to be in. They got the lead, home crowd behind them, and they're looking toward making that next step in these playoffs.
But I think a key for them is to put together some good, long, extended drives. Work the run a little more with that big offensive line. I'm not saying get away from throwing the football. That's still working. But they run it more effectively. They may get even bigger plays in the passing game.
They'll try the right side with Eckler to the 43, second down. Not a lot there. The defense was ready and looked for that run-pass option.
You get the sense the next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. Here's Herbert. And to the right side here, it's Allen. Pass midfield just before the 35. That good for 21 yards on the catch and run.
They hit that crossing route really well. Excellent timing, puts it right on him, and he keeps running.
And it turned it upfield for good yardage.
On the give, this is Eckler. And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Defensively, Sam Hubbard, the former Buckeye, there to stop him. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play.
Fucking deep.
No gain.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete. To give you an idea of how accurate he's been throwing the football, we're in the second half. That's just his second incompletion.
Well, if he's that locked in, that means everyone's locked in, because to me it's like throwing a no-hitter in baseball. The pitcher may get the credit, but a lot of people making plays behind him in the field.
Going to throw on third down with Herbert.
And those two just have been in sync thus far. They've done a nice job against him, but still, with his talent,
Brad Robinson is dead, boy.
Goddamn.
Hopkins' kick is good.
Brad Robinson is dead, boy. Drag.
You just want to keep building on that lead, don't you? Whether it's 6 points or 3 points, take everything you can get, keep maneuvering, keep adding to it, keep making it difficult for them to come back.
God damn, hoodie nigga gonna drag me to death, man. Shit. Come on now. Where the rules committee at?
Only able to gain a couple there, and that's going to set up a tough 3rd and 9.
Well, they weren't able to make anything really big out of that, but it's not a bad idea to find your tight end and give him an easy completion and keep moving things forward. Almost as bread and butter as a good running back down the play.
Burrow looking to pass.
Oh, my God. Good shit, boy. God damn.
Huber as he sends it away. Here comes Carter.
Don't slide. Let me hold that real quick. Don't slide. No.
And it'll be Charger football.
You ain't got to slide.
The Charger drive about to get going. Last time out, you remember their drive stalled, but thanks to their kicker, booted a long field goal to at least get him 3. Now here they'll try to
get his ass. Oh, that's intentional grounding. Yes, sir.
How much fun is it for coaches to know that they've got a kid that can nail it from long distance? Now, the hard part is, as an offensive play caller, you don't want that in your head too much where you're relying on it. And he goes out and gets the job done for them. But I'm quite sure he would be content to just kick extra points from here on out.
Yeah, absolutely no question. I think his teammates would be okay with him just kicking the extra points as well. They lose the yardage, and of course, they also lose the down on the grounding call, and it's quickly 2nd and long. From the shotgun, here's Herbert. For Keenan Allen, that's complete. Call it a gain of 12, but of course, not a first down due to the previous penalty. They'll be in search of 8 yards here as they hope to convert the first down. Now Herbert with it, looking to pass. And that will be incomplete.
I see the surprise in the face.
Well, the defense.
That's a rare completion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time. On is the punter, Scott, here as he gets this one away. And here's Tyler on the return. So possession goes over here on the punt. And the Bengals will have a 1st and 10 deep in their own territory. The Bengals drive about to get going. And Charles, a very uninspired effort. The last time we saw them out there was a quick three and out, and they punted the football.
Yeah, and you never want to get stopped so soundly.
That nigga jumped that bad, boy.
Derwin James with a pick.
Run the ball, man. God damn.
A 7-yard touchdown drive, and the Chargers continue to show why it pays to play at home in the postseason as they hold on their lead. Hopkins with the extra point, and the lead is up to 18 now. Following the touchdown, Dustin Hopkins will kick it away. Taylor now from the end zone. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20. The Bengals drive about to get going. I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get two more possessions.
The last run got six, now second and four. Once again, they run to Mixon. He's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. It's a Bengal first down, a pickup of 11.
Despite the score, despite the deficit, no quitting this guy. He's running angry, running through arm tackles. He wants to change what that scoreboard is saying.
Mix it up the middle, and he can only manage to get a couple. Second and eight coming up.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense, rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
On one, ready?
On second down, here's Mixon. And a 5-yard gain gets him to the 42.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Here's Burrow. This goes out wide for Mixon. And they'll get him down on the other side of midfield.
But they certainly had success throughout this contest getting him the ball in the passing game. And there he picks up another first down. Whatever they saw going into this one, they've been able to capitalize on it. And no adjustment has been made to take it away.
Out of the shotgun, they run with Mixon. He's able to break through one tackle, but it slowed him down enough that he could only manage getting back to the line of scrimmage. They've called his number a lot this afternoon. You wonder how much tread is left on those tires.
We certainly do, but I always think back to one of my favorite coaches in the NFL, and he used to have a meeting with his running backs every year in the offseason and say, look, as many times as you're going to carry the ball, you should be able to carry it one more time, so make sure you get in shape.
He'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and seven ahead.
Oh, it's time to give a little credit there to the defense. They played that very well because of the drag route. And you made up this shot, and then Romo's going straight across the field. He's hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line. But once he made the catch, nowhere to turn upfield.
And he can't find a receiver. Khalil drops him for a loss of 12, and it also brings up fourth down.
Get the safe, boy. I thought I needed a shank out there.
On the return, Carter. He'll score that 36-yard punt. And they will take over first and 10. The Charger drive about to get going. And they've got the lead here getting late into the third quarter. And the passing game for them, it's been terrific. We've seen that. But the rushing
come on, man. He's just standing there, bro. And these niggas don't come to play. Niggas just standing around.
Run blitz there defensively, something we might see more of here in the fourth quarter.
I think we'll see a lot of it, and the difference between that and a pass blitz, you're trying to get to the quarterback. You're trying to scheme someone open who will get to the QB and make sure he gets on the ground. In a run blitz, you're actually trying to cover up gaps, trying to cover up holes so they can't run the football.
And he'll go down the number four, getting this inside the 30. That one, a gain of 20 and a first down. The passing game continues to be their friend, even with a stable lead here in the fourth, Charles. They're going back to that well.
Yeah, with their overall philosophy, you know that they trust their quarterback. He's been able to throw it well. They continue to throw these safe passes. Who can blame him?
He'll get just a yard on the scramble in second down.
Well, it certainly appears to me that the defensive guys are starting to look a little bit tired while he still has some fresh legs. Not the biggest game we've seen on a scramble. But still, some positive yardage on a play that initially
a touchdown. Mike Williams with his second touchdown of the afternoon. On is Hopkins now for the extra point. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. Following the touchdown, Dustin Hopkins will kick it away. On the return, it's Taylor from his end zone. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down officially at the 21. The Bengals drive about to get going. Their hopes of advancing past this divisional round, hanging by a thread, if that, as they begin here with a first and 10 on the wrong side of the scoreboard. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
There's no question that coming into this game, this defense is pretty vocal about his desire to take this running back out of his game. And all that pregame moving has turned into results.
Now this throw caught left side. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. That one good for 26 and a first down. And with this game well in hand, perhaps we are seeing the coverage lighten up a little bit as they got burned there a bit for a first down.
Well, we certainly know the coach isn't happy along the sideline, because he certainly wants them to finish this one out the way they started it. He doesn't want to give up any soft completions, no late points. He wants his lead to stay right where it is.
Austin Johnson, the one who makes the stop defensively.
Not a lot of running room there. Not a place to make a cut and kind of exit out, because they had everything bottled up. Looked to me like the linemen were taking on their blocks really well.
What?
Giving up no creases.
What the fuck going on? Oh, my God.
From just shy midfield. She was saying she's so smart here.
She was a what?
A diesel.
You made me throw a pick.
She's
tired
and sweaty.
I know she is. You're talking about a 15-year-old, nah? Ask her who won. Ask her who won.
Here we go.
The Bengals drive about to get going. And you can sort of sense their dejection. That last pick six put the icing on the cake, so to speak, in what has been a rough go for them. There's a ball thrown right side and complete. Great way to start the drive. 20 big ones and a first down.
This game was decided. You got me, Craig. You got me, dog. I got to go fishing with Boone now. Come on, Joe. Damn.
Just before the midfield stripe at the 49. Short completion, just 4 yards, and that'll bring up second down.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people.
What the fuck?
And good for Sue yet again by the Chargers as they stuff him behind the play.
Bosa.
Sometimes you just sit back and marvel at what he can do defensively. Speed, strength, quickness. He's the whole package. And that package just wrapped up the runner for a loss.
Now Burrow loses the football. Offensively lucky they were able to keep the football. And now fourth down, so they'll have to boot it away.
I do think, though, they're going to look at this as a positive. One, they recovered the fumble, so they retained possession. But two, being able to punt it changes field position for them. Imagine if that turnover takes place there. Now your defense has to go onto the field and try and hold. Instead, they get a little breathing room.
Come
on, man. I'm a fucking corner, bro.
Forward for a modest 2 yard gain, second down.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
2 yards on the first down carry, and then followed up by 2 yards on the second down carry.
Definitely not going to be enough to get the job done. Wasn't the expression 3 yards in a cloud of dust?
Now they're going to need 6 on third down.
Oh, good fucking catch.
And he gets it all the way down inside the 10.
And let's go to bed.
That's a gain of nearly 40 yards on third and medium to pick up the first. Running on first down. And he will get into the end zone. Point good by Hopkins. And this one was over a while ago as they just hang on to that big lead.
What team was there?
Following the touchdown, Dustin Hopkins will kick it away. And Charles, I know they're going to be disappointed about several things.
Well, this nigga D-line.
They've had several turnovers. You have to think that's going to be something they're going to discuss heavily in the film session in the coming days.
Yeah, so you're right about that, partner, because they're going to have to sit in that film room and watch every error that they made and figure out how to not do it in the future. And mentally, I think a lot of the guys are already starting to think about, okay, how do we put this behind us and get better for the next time out? This, they'll use as motivation for the rest of the time that they play to hopefully never be in this type of situation again.
That was good shit, bro. Nigga, take a million fucking hours to fucking run a route.
They're
getting Craig. Dumb shit out of the fucking gate.
Because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
Ball at the 23, all the way out the fucking gate.
Once more, here's Eckler. Now third down is looming. A pickup of two on first down and just 1 yard there.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough in run support, and I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
And he's going to get this to about the 20, but that is well short of what he needed. 2 yards on the pickup there.
Yeah, I'm going to get that ball back, man.
The Bengals going to use the first of their timeouts. As they'll stop it with a little over 30 ticks to go in the football game.
Get the field goal, Craig. I don't feel no type of way. God damn. Kick that shit. Get the ball back.
And out comes Dustin Hopkins to take this kick for LA on fourth down. Hopkins' kick is good.
We would like to do it in 27, man.
The ultimate level is sure that they're going to need those 3 points, but they'll take the three and they pad that lead.
Yeah, this one's already wrapped up, but you and I both know that if you're an offensive coordinator, you never let up on the game unless the head coach tells you to do so. And maybe you've actually clicked it off in your headset so you can keep calling plays and trying to add to this lead.
Time left here, but this one not going to go their way.
And this is where, in this situation for me, you just go ahead and run out the clock, shake hands, congratulations, and move on.
Get the fuck. Come on, man. I ran out of bounds, man.
We'll see what they do here in this last sequence. That's just his second catch of the game. They wanted to keep him silent. They have kept him silent.
Defensive football 101. Don't let the best player on offense beat you. Take him out of the game. They've done a great job of doing that.
Throwing again on second down, but this time it's incomplete.
That's coverage you'd expect to see in a tight game late. Not in a lopsided game like this. They are not letting up.
After the incompletion, here now, third and two. They're passing here, Joe Burrow. And the catch made, it's Tyler Boyd. And with just inside of 10 seconds to go, they'll burn their final timeout. 9 seconds left. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. Now Burrow. He's going to let it fly.
Good game, Craig.
As time has expired, Chargers are going to continue on in these playoffs. As we say so long, everybody, thanks for watching.
Well, fellas, we gone. We done. Up for next season, Ben. Couldn't get that running game going. That's what we're doing now. Couldn't get a running game going. Damn, Joe. Couldn't get Joe going, boy. Craig, where's my motherfucking running game, boy? I tied in, Ben. Ah.